Well, good morning. It is Thursday, October 8th. I want to wish you God's blessings as we begin this day in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. It's a big day for our dog Ada. You can see she's trying to take over driving here. I'll try to adjust it a little bit. And you can see for yourself that she is she's pretty excited. Are we going to go see your friends? Are we going to go see your friends? Yeah, we are. So she's all excited because she gets to go spend a day at the whatever we call it these days, the doggy daycare or whatever. But she's going to go there and spend some time with her friends that she's been going to on occasion, not very often, since the time she was a puppy. And it's amazing. I mean, this dog will jump on my lap. I'll have to sit her aside before I start driving. And by the time we even get there closer to see her start to pick up whatever scents are in the air, whatever's going on, she'll put her nose to the vent. I mean, it's crazy. She'll start shaking the closer we get there. She's already starting to shake a little bit because she gets so excited about this whole doggy daycare thing. And I got to give them props. I got to give them credit for whatever they do there, man, because they set it up where she just cannot wait to get there. So all morning we've told her, you know, I woke up this morning and said that we were going to take her there. She's just been nuts. She has just been over the top. And like I said, I'll try to maybe add a little video clip at the end to show you how excited she gets and how she pretty much drags me to the door and greets those who are there. But, you know, I do believe, as I've said so often, there are lessons for us to be learned from God's creation, including a dog like Ada. And I think really today, I just can't help but think about how we are called to be as those who know the truth, those who understand who Christ is and what he's really done for us. I mean, you think about this, we don't have any right whatsoever in our current state apart from Christ to be in his presence. We don't have any right to even look forward to paradise, what he has established for us, what he has waiting for us. We have no right, and it's all because of our brokenness and our sinful nature and the fact that we exhibit that all the time, even when we know we shouldn't. And yet, we still are given the greatest gifts ever. I mean, Jesus Christ has, through his life, his death, his resurrection, passed on to you and me the most undeserved and yet overwhelming gifts that can exist in our lives. I mean, that's really what it comes down to. It's what matters most. And it really is a reminder that then when we have the opportunity to worship him, which is essentially every day, we should come into his presence with thanksgiving and praise. In fact, Psalm chapter 100, I would encourage you to read the entire psalm. I know some of those psalms are long, but go ahead and read it. It's only five verses, but it talks about entering his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. And just the entire psalm is about how we are to live our lives as his people. And it to me, it's just, again, that great reminder of all that we've been given and all that we have to rejoice over. And so today, as my friends in Christ, I just want to encourage you to do that. You don't have to be in a physical church building to do that. You can do it in so many creative ways. Share the joy that you have in Christ Jesus. Share it with others. Let it show. I mean, so often, maybe it's due to our cultural heritage, maybe it's the way we've been raised, whatever, we tend to try to contain things. And folks, when it comes to the joy of the Lord, we got to stop that stuff. We need to just let it flow. We just need to let it show. And in fact, we need to, again, take after this little mutt here and just let our feelings go and not let them be contained when it comes to the love that we have in Christ Jesus, the wonderful Savior that we have in him and what he has done for us. So with that said, why don't we go to him in prayer? And then again, I'll try to show you a little clip of what happens when we get to the doggy daycare. So let's pray. Gracious God, Heavenly Father, we do thank you for all things. And I thank you, Lord, for the wonderful examples that you set before us, even through your creation. I ask, Lord, that you would just simply just let all those things that get in the way of us showing how much joy we have, let those things, those barriers, be set aside. remove them from us so that we can truly share the joy that we have in Christ Jesus and all that he's done, all those things that he's given us that we never deserve. So Lord, let us today come before you in your presence with thanksgiving and with praise, and let others see you in us. We pray this in your precious name. Amen. All right, well, I got to hit the road, and like I said, maybe a little clip to show you the insanity that happens when we get close to the daycare. God's blessings. All right, so we're here, so here you go. I'm just going to give you a little preview of the insanity that takes place and the, I guess, the rejoicing in a dog. So if she can do it, I think we can too.
Oh, my God.